don't mind if I record.
You're Captain Melody. Don't need my permission.
So how's it look out there, Hank?
Well, I found some more survivors. Started shooting at me the second they saw me. Like the rest.
Sounds about par for the course. Seems like there's not a sane mind south of Mount Blair. Anything else?
Ash is piling up faster than we expected. But going by the maps the earlier teams did, it at least doesn't seem to be spreading anymore.
So, we've only lost Welsh, Beckley, Lewisburg, and everything around them. Little blessing, I suppose.
Oh, and actual good news. Irahan Mining.
Been a long time since I've heard good news in Irahan Mining. Back to back.
No kidding. When that excavator armor they made ruined the company. Rumor is it's tough as nails, and they still got the plans on site. Could you imagine what a patrol would be like if we could figure out how to make those things?
Yeah, locals would hopefully be a lot less inclined to shoot first.
Bingo. You give me a day or two. I can head back down there, see what I can do.
No. Garahan can wait. We need rest. Head up. That excavator armor will still be there. Now go.
Your overseer says, "Hello, Vault Dweller. Glad you made it to Charleston." You can gear up here. Responders, set up this trading post for their fire breathers unit. Nice to see more people coming to Charleston. This city, seen a lot. You know the drill. Buy and sell. You need supplies. I am programmed to trade. Match made in heaven.
Carter. Are we still looking for Governor Evans? Is it true that Holbrook is the acting governor?
No. The line of secession clearly states that the speaker outranks the majority whip.
Look, I don't have time for... Is it true that a mob of zombies attacked a southwestern checkpoint?
What foolish... No. It was people affected by the radiation. There's a passel of them over in the medical center. Poor souls.
Has there been any word from Washington yet, ma'am? Are we still at war? What about the mutations and the reports of the people seeing the Mothman?
Okay, that's enough. The Herald used to be an upstanding paper, and y'all are fixing to turn it into a rag. This is a closed session. Marshall, see that our friend finds her way out. Mothman. Really?
You heard her. Closed session. No reporters.
Oh, damn it. Fine. But there have been reports of people seeing the Mothman.
Uh-huh. Get out of here before I pull your press badge.
Okay. I'm going. You don't have to shove.
All right, it's recording. Thank you again for reaching out to me. I can't tell you how shocked I was to find out your letter was the real deal.
Of course, Miss Carter. The threat wasn't fun.
It was an experience. Not a lot of my interviews start with a bag. Just glad it didn't end up being a prank, I suppose.
I apologize for that. Maintaining a low profile is a requirement for us now.
And why is that, Senator? Why did you leave your position so suddenly?
Leaving was the only way I thought I'd be able to protect my family, Miss Carter. But I've since realized that I've left a lot of other people I care about in grave danger. I was hoping you could help me correct that.
What are you talking about, Senator?
There are sinister forces at work in the halls of government. I and my fellow members of the Free States will no longer be shackled to the putrefying corpse of this nation. No, nor should anyone who values their lives. There is only one recourse left for the people of the United States. Strike out on your own. Take whatever you can carry, get off the grid, and get there fast. The end is coming, Mrs. Carter. And when it does, your government has no interest in keeping you safe.
Sinister forces? The end is coming? Senator, you're making some big claims here. Do you have evidence to back it up?
This is not some doomsday fever dream, if that's what you're asking, Miss Carter. I received my information from reliable sources. Yes.
And I'm supposed to take your word for it?
You're going to have to, Miss Carter. I'm trying to save lives, not put more at risk by exposing my sources.
Senator, I'm not trying to be rude here, but it sounds like you're trying to start a panic, and without evidence, I'm not willing to be a part of that. I also have it under the strictest confidence that you've been seen making multiple visits to a certain Charleston neurologist as of...
My health is not the issue here, Miss Carter. These are people's lives. The executive branch, captains of industry, the Department of Agriculture. I peeked into their world and they threatened my life, my daughter's life. We're just pawns to them. And the only way we survive is to step off the board. All I'm asking is that you share that message.
I meant no offense. You just have to know how this looks from my end.
I understand. It's just a sensitive topic.
Would you mind if I asked you one last question?
If it means you'll get the word out, go ahead.
You never resigned as senator. Is that something you're planning to do?
I am. Consider this interview a formal resignation. Spread the word, Miss Carter. All I ask is that my warning goes with it, and nothing else. Now, if you wouldn't mind, my daughter and I have a lot to do. We're on our own out here, after all.
I'm William Breyer, investigative reporter for the Charleston Herald. I'm currently standing just outside the security fencing of one of several Hornride industrial sites that have cropped up around the area in recent months. I'm here tonight to try and get some answers about what has become known in certain circles as Motherlode Project. Could this be the answer local mining families have been looking for? A series of new mining projects that could reinvigorate the local economy? Or, as the environmental groups have suggested, could these be a fresh set of toxic disposal sites, poisoning the ground beneath our feet? At the very least, according to local experts, the area's recent increase in seismic events can almost certainly be tied to these sites. And now I'm here to see for myself what's really going on. I've just made my way up to a small gap in the first line of fencing. The security here is intense. Barbed wire, armed guards. Feels like a war zone. I'm making my way over a small ridge and I...
Mother of God! Ground shaking and...
Oh my God. What is that?
Hey, you! This is private property!
Shit, it's that reporter. Jesus.
He's got a gun!
Gun? Wait, this isn't a...
examination will begin in 15 seconds. Exam initiated. Activate initial checkpoint. Checkpoint activated. Physical examination complete. Time unacceptable. Please try again. Examination will begin in 15 seconds. Exam initiated. Activate initial checkpoint. Checkpoint activated. Return to start. Congratulations, applicant. Please access terminal to initiate final examination briefing.
Greetings, applicant. This is Melody Larkin, Fire Breather's captain. Congratulations on your progress thus far. Until recently, we'd now be moving you on to our final exam. A nice, easy run through an active mind burn. But these days, we got bigger fish to fry. The scorched creatures have been pouring through Big Bend Tunnel. Someone has to stop them. The fire breathers are the only ones with the tools and the know-how to get it done. So, for your final exam, you'll be running a course cooked up by our very own Lieutenant Madigan to get you up to speed on dealing with these scorched. Head on over to the Belch and Betty shaft when you're ready. Our handler bot, Bernie, will get you oriented. Come back alive and human, and you're in.
fire breather. Applicant detected. Kit ticket issued. Please collect your gear. Final examination instructions will be issued with applicant equipment.
Welcome, recruit, to your final exam. I'm Hank Madigan, Fire Breather Lieutenant. Exam simple. Reach the bottom of the mine, hit the emergency beacon down there, and come back up. All you gotta do is survive a little slice of living hell and all the scorch that call it home. And I get this is extreme, but we need to know if you can hack it before you got half a dozen other people counting on you. But you're not going in empty-handed. Along with your suit, you've been issued a modified 10mm. We figured out the Scorch aren't big fans of depleted ultrasite. Took a field trip to AMSHQ to figure out how to make the stuff, but it's the most effective tool we found for putting them down. So time to prove you can put it to good use. Suit up, strap in, and move out, recruit.